Jairus to his house.
Right.
And when he gets to Jairus' house, the Bible says that after he threw out the critics and the naysayers, the Bible says that after he put out the folk that were just there for the chicken and the Kool-Aid,
all right.
The Bible says, my brothers and my sisters, that he told the girl, he touched her and called her, he said, Tabitha Kuma, which means little damsel, wake up. And the Bible says that she sat up, and the Bible says not only did she sit up, but she began to eat. Can I tell you that Jairus got both a word and a touch? But there were others in the Bible where Jesus never really put his hands on them, but told them by his word that you are healed. There are others in the Bible where Jesus put his hands on them, but their healing was not in effect until they did what Jesus told them to do. And I've got to leave you now, but not only was she healed emotionally or externally, but can I tell you that she was healed emotionally? For the Bible says that she began to glorify God. This poor, shamed and broken woman stood up straight. And she began to praise God. Her pain was replaced with her praise. And her shame had been replaced with a shout. And I'm through when I tell you, my brothers and my sisters, that when you read the text says that she immediately began to glorify God. That doesn't mean that she praised him one time and stopped, but that means that every time that she was able to realize that she was no longer bent down, but now she was standing straight up, she opened her mouth and began to praise the name of God. A question tonight. Can I slide through your front door? Come by your kitchen, grab a glass of Kool-Aid, and sit in your living room and ask you tonight, can you praise God? Has he done anything for you that he's worthy of your praise? I don't know about anybody else in here tonight, but to praise the Lord. I don't know how you feel about it, but I've got a right to praise the Lord. Well, Fernando, tell me, why do you have a right to praise the Lord? I have a right to praise him because he's done so much for me. From death, is there anybody here that can help me testify that the amount of weed I used to smoke should have me crazy? I should be cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. I should be somewhere in the insane asylum. But I'm sitting in here tonight. I may be a little touched, but I'm in my right mind. Is there then you look back over your life and remember when Bozo left you, you didn't lose your mind. Is there anybody here that can look back over your life and see what God has done for you? hired somebody here that did not mind being seen and did not mind for knowing your business to reach over and grab your neighbor by the hand and say, neighbor, I don't know about you, but I've got a reason to praise the Lord. Bye.